Okay, let's pray. Father, we just come before you, Lord, and we desire, Father God, that you will really speak to us, to your people, teach us your ways. It is only by walking in your ways that we experience your presence, the manifest presence in our daily life, and that we will always, Lord, witness your glory. Father, that I ask the Holy Spirit to manifest, O God, his power by opening the eyes and the understanding of your people to receive your word. And I pray, O God, that pour your grace upon us, that we have, Lord, we will be humble enough to receive your message. And let us not be just doers of the word, but be hearers, not just hearers of the word, but be doers of your word, O God. I pray, Father God, also that you are my stay and my support. You are my strength. Thank you, Lord, for you enable me to bring this message to your people, that we will all learn, O God, how to walk with you in humility, in purity, in love, and in grace. And I thank you, Lord, for what you will do. For I decree and declare as your servant that this will be a victorious, a glorious, and powerful seminar, that everyone, O God, will, Lord, be transformed by renewing of our minds, by giving us, O Lord, your truth. Knowing the truth will set us free. Even now, Father, I give you praise and glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So good afternoon once again. I will be studying about biblical characters. So importante po talaga na natututunan natin yung mga characters in the Bible. Kasi hindi lamang po tayo natututo sa buhay natin. We learn from our mistakes, our experiences. But sa mga tao sa paligid natin, but especially sa mga buhay sa Bible. So I'll focus on the book of Genesis, and then the part 2, I'll focus on the characters of the kings, and then on the May 1, we'll be teaching about the New Testament characters. So it will be very amazing, okay, matutunan natin. This is a compilation of my study all these years being a Christian when God called me, and plus mga books that I have gathered. And really, it really enriched my life spiritually, and it helped me to be strong in my conviction being a Christian all these years. So as I impart these things, I pray that it will really bring comfort, encouragement, and courage to really press on to the high calling of God. Hindi po kasi madali talaga maging Kristiyano. It's not a walk in the park. It is a battle. You have to overcome Satan, the world, and our flesh. But you see, the cross of Christ made provisions already. Kaya lang, bakit hindi po natin madalas, majority of the Christians, hindi na experience the victory and the power of the cross? Simply because we have not really exhaust and research the truth. Only, it's not just truth that sets us free. It's knowing the truth. Kasi truth has been released. It's been preached, and yet, bakit wala po talagang transformation? The essence of Christianity is transformation, to be more like Christ. Ang hirap po kasing simba tayo na simba, and yet hindi nakikita yung pagbabago sa atin. We become ineffective and unproductive being a Christian. We need to be really effective and productive so that they will witness that we are really the people of God. So, we'll start with sabi dyan sa Romans 15:4, for whatever was that's written in former days was written for instruction, that by our steadfast and patient endurance and encouragement drawn from the scriptures, we might hold fast to and cherish hope. So, sinasabi, the Old Testament, okay, it was written for us. Kaya marami po ako na papansin na pag ang focus lang natin sa the New Testament, we miss half of what God is telling us, is teaching us. We must know and understand the whole counsel of God. Kaya lang, kailangan din natin na understanding, because once we do not understand the Word of God, Satan can steal that from us. Kahit basa ka ng basa, without understanding, we cannot really, we're still lost. That's why we need the illumination of the Holy Spirit so that we will continue to be enlightened. That's why the prayer of Paul was that we will be enriched, okay? That we will that our hearts be flooded with light. And then secondly, sabi dito, by our steadfast and patient endurance and the encouragement. Saan natin dapat hinuhugot daw yan? Yung patience natin to really endure to our life adversities, to the challenges, the tribulation, the everything that we will face in life as a Christian. Okay? Saan daw? Drawn from the scriptures. So, bakit daw? So, when once we really have a revelation from God through the Word of God, then we can really hold fast to and cherish hope. So, kahit sa buhay natin, we really need to be enriched with the Word of God. But not just the knowledge of the Word of God, but understanding the revelation of what does it mean. Kaya nga importante na we are really built by the revelation. Remember, sabi ni Jesus Christ, upon this rock, I will build my church. So, paano niya tayo binibuild? It is by revelation of who Christ is. Kasi ang mahirap, pag tayo po as Christians, we just know about God, but we do not know Him intimately, experientially, then we only have religion. And so, we're no different from other unbelievers who have religion. Tayo dapat we have a relationship. Because the essence of Christianity is transformation. The question is, have you been transformed all these years? Have you become more like Christ? If not, then maybe you're not really a child of God. The purpose of God is to really transform us. Okay. So number one is about Noah. So we are familiar with Noah. If you will read the Genesis, the very first thing, the very first time that you will encounter grace is in the life of Noah, because Noah finds grace. Okay? The key factor in life is to find grace and favor in the sight of God. For all things come from God. Okay? He is the giver of wisdom, and He is the one who plans our lives. His divine plan can only be fulfilled by grace. We cannot fulfill it on our own strength, on our own understanding. That's why Proverbs says that we do not lean on our own understanding. Trust in the Lord with all our heart and lean not on our own understanding. So which translates to what? What is grace? Kasi minsan, mali po yung interpretation natin ng grace, okay? Grace is enablement. He's giving us enablement, power yan within us to accomplish His will upon the earth. God will accomplish His will on the earth through people. Hindi yan bababa dito and yet He will just, ano yun, magic. Hindi po. Kailangan po He accomplish it with us, through us. Okay? God wants to work with His people. Kaya naman niya i-accomplish lahat eh. Diba? He's so powerful. All-powerful ang Diyos. But He chose to work with us and through us. That's why it is through grace alone. Okay? And by grace and through faith. That's why the just shall live by faith. So, importante po, there are keys to being recipient of God's grace. Paano ba natin matatanggap ang biyaya ng Diyos? So, sa scriptures we are given what? James 4:6, but He gives grace, more grace. Therefore, He says, God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. So, more grace if we humble ourselves before God. So, what does it mean to be humble before God? It is dependent on God. Humility means agreeing with God. That's why we cannot be humble enough before God without agreeing with God. Because if we do not agree with God, then we will go on our own way. The essence of sin is what? I'll do it my way. And that's what's happening in the lives of many people. I'll do it my way. That's why they just set aside God. Even in Christianity. So we need to understand humility starts when we agree with God. And then we depend on Him. So the more we depend on Him, ibig sabihin, the more we become humble and the more grace will be available to us. God will pour grace. That's why He says in the life of Paul, sabi niya, he was asking God to remove this thorn in the flesh, sabi niya, my grace is sufficient. So it will always be sufficient in our life if we will continue to agree with God. And then, depend on God. That's what humility is all about. It's not saying na, hindi ko kaya to. That's not humility. That's false humility. And then what? In Psalm 50:23, whoso offereth praise, this is the King James Version, glorified me, and to him that order his conversation, all right, I will show the salvation of God. Okay. So number two, okay, requirement ng Panginoon for us to receive grace is our conversation. We need to watch what's coming out of our mouth. We need to be pure in our words. Kaya hindi po pwede na tayo ay nagsisinungaling, hindi tayo nagmumura. As Christians, we really have to overcome all this. Kasi nga, pag na-transform ang heart natin, automatic po yan, matatransform din yung ating pananalita. So, we will be careful with our words, with the choice of words. Be careful what we say, and especially what comes out from our mouth. Kasi it comes from the heart. That's why we have to really ask the Lord, Lord, create in me a pure heart. Because to the pure, everything is pure. It will come out pure when everything is pure from the inside. Hindi po yan outside. Kaya nga, ang Christianity, it comes from inside. Sa loob, nag-uumpisa ang pagbabago, hindi sa labas. Because pag palabas lang, sa labas lang, pakitang tao, then makita natin, it's hypocrisy. That's what Pharisees did in the times of Jesus. Marami silang tradition of men, pinapractice, and yet there's no change of heart. God is looking for a heart that is willing to be transformed. Because once our heart is changed, then everything will change in our life. Our words, our character, everything, our thought life, our ways. So what else? And the man, he said, so Job 28:28, behold, the fear of the Lord, that is wisdom, and to depart from evil is understanding. What does it mean? What does God require? It is what? The fear of God. You see, when you have fear of God, you, sabi sa Proverbs, that your life will be filled with life, with riches and honor. I'm not saying that when you have all this, life will be easy. No, it is not. I'm saying that you will experience God in a way that you will be an overcomer. You see, when you have the favor of God and the grace of God, you're able to overcome all adversities in life. You will fight. You will not allow circumstances to defeat you, but you overcome because the grace is always sufficient. Okay? Now, the following aspects of the life and times of Noah are very, very important. Remember, the Lord Himself likened the last days to the times of Noah. Remember, Jesus Christ mentioned about Noah. Okay, why it's so important? Noah was spared during the judgment of God. And we are told in our day that we should pray that we may be counted. It is found in Luke 21:36. Jesus said this himself, okay? Sabi niya, watch ye therefore and pray always that you may be accounted worthy to escape all these things. Prior to this verse, he enumerated the things that will happen upon the earth. So, sabi niya, nagbigay siya ng counsel na sabi niya na, pray that you will be worthy to escape all these things that that shall come to pass. So it will happen. Okay, it is in our days because we are in the last days. Jesus Christ is coming back soon. And to stand before the Son of Man. That's what I've been praying, the Lord, make me worthy, even my family, to really escape all this that's coming. So we need to really pray about it and work it out. And then what? At the same time, then, syempre, we need to really grow in the knowledge of God. Sabi rin sa Prophet Zephaniah, reminds us that in order to be preserved in the times of judgment, we have to meet certain conditions. And what is that? Seek the Lord, all who are humble, and follow His commands. Seek to do what is right and to live humbly. So, makita natin dito, mga kapatid, God desires for us to seek Him. Marami kasi nag-claim ng verse, alam ko, sa very popular verse sa Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you, and not to give you a hope and a future. But you see, it stopped there. Kiniklaim natin. But the next verse is, sabi doon, when you seek me with all your heart, and you will find me. So, God's plan for our lives will be fulfilled as we continue to seek Him. Why? The reason why I taught that one Sunday, the importance of seeking God. Because on our own, we cannot manage, we cannot live our life in a way that is pleasing before God. It is only by His grace, and that through faith, and that we allow God to really direct our steps, guide us every step of the way, so that our life will be glorifying Him. Kaya madalas po kasi ano eh, hindi natin sinisikti na sa tabi lang natin ng Diyos. And which is dapat po ano, it is a regular thing to seek the Lord. Hindi po tayo pwedeng matapos ang araw hindi tayo nagtanong, nagsisik sa Diyos. Kailangan nagtatanong po tayo, even what I do in life, what my appointment and everything, even this seminar, I have to ask God, what is this? Kasi when I'm composing the message, sabi ko, ang haba-haba nito, I cannot really preach this in one time, preaching. So I have to divide because it's so rich, okay, in the truth. Noah, he was called righteous man, okay? He was just a righteous man who always did those things that were right in God's eyes. You know what it means to be just and right? It's to do things right in the eyes of God. Okay, you need to understand. Tayo po kasi, it's easy to really choose between good and evil. When we are presented between choosing good and evil, we can really choose easily. We choose good. But the thing is, what about when we are faced with choices between from what is from God and it looks good? From God, between God and good. Mahirap po puliin yun. Because it might sound good, it may look good, but ang question is it from God? So, kailangan po matuto tayo magsalita. That's where sinasabi ng Diyos, you seek me, so I will tell you, I will show you ano yung acceptable sa akin. Kasi since man sinned, when Adam disobeyed God and Eve, what happened? Man determined what is right and wrong in their life. Tayo na yung nagtakda ng tama at mali. But then, being a Christian, binabalik tayo kaya nga by faith. Everything is by faith. Why? Binabalik tayo dahil binabalik din natin ang moral authority to determine what is right and wrong saan? Kay God. Hindi na tayo magtatakda ng tama to, mali to. No, it is will be God's standard. Kasi if we do not live the standard of God and we continue to live according to what we think is right, then we'll never really realize that we are still living in a disobedient path. Kaya nga, importante nung sasabi sa John 14, I think 21, sabi doon, na those who have my commandments, so very first requirements, those who have my commandments and obey them, this it shows that what? These people are really love me. Kasi madali magsabi, Lord, I love you. Okay, so how do you know? How do you prove that you love God? Have you been obedient? So sabihin natin, yes. Paano? Do we have integrity? Do we have honesty in our daily life? When it comes to money, I mean, dealing with people, I mean, being trusted with money, being, you know, do we deceive? Do we lie? Sometimes kasi may rami nagsasabi na it's a white lie. Ano ba yun? White lie? May color coding ba kasalanan? Wala. It's either black or white. So wala pong color ang kasalanan. It's just black. So makita natin, we need to really live according to the word. And sabi nga dyan, he's perfect. What does it mean to be perfect? Blameless. Walang isisisi. Ay, hirap yata nun mamuhay na walang isisisi sa atin because people tend to judge us, di ba? Parang, kasi people, ang ugali ng mga tao is, ano eh, madaling manisi. But then, pagka tayong natuto na sa paraanan ng Diyos, we learn not to blame people kaagad. Balik lang tayo sa sarili natin. Bakit nangyari to? Ako to eh, hindi yung sa tao. Okay? So, sabi nga that there's a way that seems right to a man. So, madalas, alam natin, tama, pero in the eyes of God, mali. So no one lived what a righteous and just life. Perfect. It means wala siya ikakahiya. Walang isisisi sa kanya. Undefiled by corruption of his day. Napakahirap po manatiling puro sa corruption, sa influence ng society natin. Napakahirap po na mag-stand in righteousness, to stand in the truth. Marami po sa atin na hindi tayo makapagsalita kaming tama kasi natatakot tayo na isasabihin ng tao sa atin. You know, the fear of man is a snare, sabi sa Bible. So, we should overcome the fear of man. We should fear God alone. So, makita natin, nowadays, everything is open. Walang absolute sa buhay ng mga tao, even among Christians. We should have absolute. There should never be options na alam mo to na sabi nga nila, honesty is the best policy. I don't like that quote. You know why? So if that is considered the best, so you can also make it better or good. But if I say honesty is the only policy, there's no other way. Kasi pag sinabi mo best, you can choose, I can make it better, parang less best. Then you can make it less better by being good. But if you make it the only policy, then you live in that principle of being honest all the time. You know why how to develop honesty is having integrity in all aspects. Kasi pag may integrity tayo, madaling maging totoo. You don't have to pretend, you don't have to lie. You have integrity. Kahit walang nakakakita, honest ka. You know what's one thing that the leaders fall, madaling mag-fall from the ministry, from success? Because of what? Pride, immorality, and greed. Once you do not allow God to deal with these three things, three aspects, more or less the enemy has inroad in your life to really pull you down. Kaya importante, are we honest, especially sa money matters? Ito po yung napaka-struggle ng maraming Christians. Remember, I thought about the love of money. Kasi ito po yung hindi tayo mabuhay ng security natin sa money. You know what? I find it, I am more secured when I put my security in God more than what I have. Kasi what I have can be lost in a day, but what I have in God can never be lost. It is kept by the power of God. And I will never live in lack. Bakit? Because God is my provider. So, hindi ko siya, I will not hold on. Okay? When God says, give this up, I'll give this up. Kaya importante po talaga na we have integrity in all aspects. Especially when it comes to what? Money. As Christians, let us be honest in this area. Wala po tayong... Kaya nga, I don't believe in solicitation, I don't believe in humihingi, I don't believe in, parinig, I don't do that. Because my God is my only provider. Okay? So, Noah walked with God. So, this is important. You see, I've been meditating on Micah 6:8, sabi doon, act justly, love mercy, and walk humbly before God. That is the requirements of God. So, how do we act justly? We have to be fair to everybody without being prejudiced. Kasi tayo, madali tayo maging biased, especially when someone hurt us, we become biased, di ba? Biased are, I'm natin yung tao, we treat them differently. Dapat po hindi. Kailangan, pag sinabi ni Lord, act justly, kahit sinaktan ka yan, sa next dealing mo with that person, wala kang prejudice. Wala kang isipin na, ito, ginawa nito eh, kaya I will not give him the favor, give her the favor. Meron ka ng prejudice kagad dun eh. You know what it means to act justly? Be fair, regardless if these people, is fair to you. You cannot just copy their behavior because simply they are like that. I mean, we as Christians must always be above. Yun ang sinasabi na, be holy, be perfect. What does it mean? Hindi ibig sabihin we are sinless. Ibig sabihin, we should be above. We treat people the way God treats us. Pagka nasaktan ka niya, hindi yan iniisip mo gaganti ka. Then, you're not acting justice. Okay? So, kailangan when we say, act justly, be fair to everybody. Hindi lang yung mga, kasi sa mga mission work ko, napapansin ko, meron mga nagre-reklamo mga members na pag mayaman, they're given, special attention. Pag mahirap ka, you're not given special attention. God is angry when we treat people like that. Ayaw niya yun. Kaya you have to be fair to everybody regardless of their social standing, to their behavior, attitude. Alam mo, talagang napakahirap po nasa ministry because we're dealing with lots of people. But you see, this is the requirement. That's why it is important that you really ask the Lord to give you the grace to act justly without being prejudiced. And then what? Love mercy. Kasi if you are being prejudiced, you cannot what? You cannot really be merciful towards others. And then what? And then you cannot walk humbly before God. You are not agreeing with God. From the first requirement, hindi ka na makaka-walk kay God. You cannot walk with God anymore. So we need to really act justly, and that is what it means to be walk with God. Okay? So, Noah walked with God, and that is important. We need to walk with God. Okay? There is a submission na dederail tayo, nalulos tayo, nadadaba tayo, nagkakamali tayo. You see, when you are yoked with God, sabi nga niya, those who are weary and heavy laden, sabi niya, take my yoke, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. You know what is to be yoked with God? Yung, I don't know the Tagalog for this, but you see, yung sa farming, di ba, merong yoke yun. Tapos, doon ginaguide ng farmer yung kalabaw. But then, pag merong maliit na yoke, nilalagay sa maliit na karabaw para yung malaking, yung matandang karabaw, siya na yung maglilit. So when we are yoked with God, kahit nadederail tayo, because we are yoked with Him, nahihila niya tayo. Kasi hindi naman tayo magkakamali tayo sa buhay, okay? So it is important that when we walk with God, regardless of our mistakes and shortcomings, God will always pull us back to His path. Kaya kasi alam niya, part of our human nature, magkakamali tayo, magkakasala tayo, papalpak tayo. So, makita niya natin. But you see, Noah has flaws in his character. So, and then what? And then, he knew the secrets of God and understood that the flood was coming. Because of his walk with God, ano nangyari yan? Aware siya sa mangyayari. Okay? The coming flood. Because God will always reveal His plan to those who fear Him. Nakita natin yan sa Psalm 25:14 in Amplified Version. The secret, okay? Secret nga eh, no? Of the sweet, satisfying companionship of the Lord have they who fear, revere, and worship Him, and He will show them His covenant and reveal to them its deep inner meaning. You see, where does it come from? It is from the intimacy of fellowshipping with Jesus Christ that God will really reveal to us the secret, okay? The covenant. Ito yung mangyayari, okay? So, reveal to them its deep inner meaning. So, kasi the Bible, the Word of God is so mysterious that we never understand on our own. We need the illumination of the Holy Spirit. Kaya lang, pagkababasahin mo siya, kailan din natin ang revelation. And God reveals that, gives that revelation to those what? Who fear Him. Okay? Who's fellowshipping with Him. Kaya nga ang tanong, are you fellowshipping with Christ? Kailangan po natin, nagpe-fellowship po tayo kay Lord para alam natin, okay? So, importante po na we need to understand what's coming. Ako, not all the time, okay? But there are things that He would reveal to me that is only for me and for the body of Christ. Kaya pagka meron siyang sinasabi, so I'll keep it and then until I will wait for God's time kung kailan niya ipapababa. There are so many revelations na tatanggap ko lately and dinadahan-dahan lang niya ako because overwhelming din po yung revelation ni Lord. Okay? Now, this is Noah. What do we learn from Noah? It is only by walking with God and so faithful. Imagine he preached about the coming of the flood and no one listened. And yet, he persevered. He was faithful to the call of God in his life. And then what he finds? Grace. So, we need grace in our life every day. We cannot really afford na hindi tayo makakatanggap ng biyay. Without the grace, we cannot make it in this life. We will give up. So what else? We have to really walk with God. And then what? Then be faithful. Be faithful in the task that God has given us. And eventually, when God fulfills that call, the rewards is so tremendous, amazing, far greater than what we expect. So I pray that you learn a little about the life of Noah. Kasi medyo nag-focus ako kay Abraham, kay Joseph, and to other because their life was so rich. Okay? So sa life of Abraham, Abraham represents the true pattern of inheriting the promises of God. He's a prototype pattern. Okay? He is a pattern to the children of faith sa atin. So ano ibig sabihin yan? So, pag-aralan mo ang life ni Abraham, he was given a promise. So he knew God has a promise in his life. As a Christian, you should seek God for His promises in your life. His promise in my life may not be His promise for your life. Iba-iba tayo kasi iba-iba yung buhay natin. So, iba-iba yung promises niya. My promise, God's promise in my life is entirely different from yours. So, kailangan, meron tayong pinangahawakan na pangako ng Diyos. Why? Because we have a goal to reach. Without a goal to reach, we become careless. Hindi tayo passionate about Christ. We tend to lose the fire in our heart. Bakit? Wala tayong pinangahawakan, wala tayong pinaglalaban eh. Pero once you get to know the promises of God, alam mo pinanghahawakan mo, ano mo ang paglalaban mo, alam mo that I have a goal to reach. Kasi pag careless tayo, the world can pull us down. Kasi the temptation is there. Andiyan lagi ang temptation. Hindi mawawala yan because we are in the flesh. As long as we're in the flesh, pag sinasabi mo, well, you're not in the flesh, hindi patay ka na pala. We're in the flesh. We need to battle it out. Kaya makikita mo, pagka, when I'm faced with a lot of temptations, a lot of adversity, a lot of discouragement, I will always ask the Lord, Lord, what is your word for this? Kasi pangahawakan ko. Remember, I was sick last December and my condition was not good, okay? But hiningi ko kay Lord, what is your promise regarding this? Para may pangahawakan ako. Kasi pag may pinangahawakan ako, alam ko kung ano yung pinaglalaban ko. Alam ko what I'm about to overcome. And I know what I'm getting. So, lalaban ka. Kasi kung wala tayong promises, ano yun? Para yung buhay mo as Christians, para you're always in the wilderness. You have nothing to look forward to in life. Para wala ka excitement. Alam mo, there are times na I'm so down. Kasi it happened to me. See, I'm human as I am. Nararamdaman ko rin yan. Nagda-down ako sobra. Okay, kasi because of overwhelming responsibility as the head pastor, and then what? May challenges sa health ko, tapos may challenges pa sa so many things, sa aspect. You know what really keeps me up? When God reminds me of what? Di ba the Holy Spirit who will remind us of what God told us in the past. So anong mangyayari? It really, alam mo, na-revive yung heart ko. Nga, no, may promise ni Lord, sige, laban ulit. Alam mo yun? Kasi meron kang ini-aim. Kaya at the end of the year, tinitignan ko na accomplish ko ba yung goal ko. Kasi Lord, ito yung goal ko. Ito yung hinihingi ko. There are times, you know, sa intercession when we pray, merong revelation. And then sabi ko, Lord, I will not accept that revelation. Kasi may pangako ka. So what I did is to really pray it through until sabi ni Lord, okay. So sabi nga ng Panginoon, di ba, the violent take it by force. It's not about being violent, okay? It's ibig sabihin, are you determined to receive the promises of God? Okay? So ito po si Abraham, the life of Abraham is a pattern to the children of faith. His walk will show us how we too can inherit the promises and blessing. Kaya lang, ang tanong, how many promises are left unclaimed because of a failure to allow the words of the promise to test us? Okay. You need to understand, once we receive a promise from God, it will be tested severely in our life. My goodness, I've been there many times. I have tremendous promises from God. Kaya I have tremendous trials. But that keeps me going. Okay. So it will be tested. Kaya nga, many times, na Christians, hindi sila nagtatanong kay Lord kasi natatakot silang masaktan, natatakot silang matest. One thing I learned in life, don't be afraid to get hurt. Because pain is a gift. You may not agree with me, but in my experience, pain has become a gift in my life. God has brought me this far and what I have become. Because of all the trials, the pain, the sorrow, the disappointments, the frustrations I experienced in the past. And when I look back in my life, I said, I thank you, dinaanan ko lahat yun. Because I will never appreciate the beauty of life, the love of God, the faithfulness of God, if I did not experience the valley, to walk in the valley of death, to walk in the darkest time of your life. Because it is only through darkness that the light of God, the guidance of God is so real. The presence of God, when I am so hurting, God's presence is so real. Why? Because I'm so broken. And I appreciate all those pains because I get to know the Lord more. And I get closer and then I develop my dependency on Him. And then what? I will be kept from pride. Why? Because I grow more dependency on God. The reason why pride is being created in our hearts because we lose our dependency on God. But when you are really down, in pain, confused, sometimes all this, you tend to really hold on to God. Lord, hindi ko kaya to. You depend on God, and yet God will manifest Himself. So sabi ko, Lord, there's no way. I mean, ayaw natin masaktan. Sino ba gusto masaktan? Sino ba yung gusto ma-reject, di ba? But those times that I've experienced all this, I experienced the reality of who God is in my life. And with that, I learned pain is a gift. So the more you get hurt, the more you become soft before God. And once you become soft before God, then the next time you get hurt, it's not deep anymore. Hindi na malalim. Bakit? Nabasag na yung pagkatao mo eh. You know, usually naman ang binabasag ni Lord dyan, yung pride natin, yung ego natin eh, di ba? So, let us allow God to test us so that we can claim the promises of God. Now, in Genesis 12:1, now the Lord had said to Abram, get out of your country, from your family, from your father's house, to a land that I will show you. Okay, this is very important, okay, pointers. When I asked the Lord, sabi ko, Lord, bakit sinabi mo, I will show you? This is not specific. Okay? In God, that's why when God appeared to us and sinabi niya, oh Grace, punta ka lang Quezon City, pupunta ako Quezon City, but that's not faith. Kasi alam ko, exactly is the specific sinabi ng Diyos. God will start us with what? General will. Bakit? To develop faith. To allow us, you know, He allows mistakes in our life para ano, matuto tayo sa pagkakamali natin. At pag natuto tayo sa pagkakamali natin, then we grow in wisdom, we grow in courage, we grow in bravery. Lahat yan nag-grow. If we learn, okay? Hindi lahat po na nagkakamali, eh, natututo. So, kailangan, natuto ba tayo sa pagkakamali natin? Do we become a better person? Do we learn? Do we gain wisdom? So, nakita natin, it is a general will. Because God is waiting for us to mature. Kasi, pagka nag-specific will na, at hindi pa tayo ready, ang nangyayari, mga kapatid, we tend to disobey God. So, ang alam ng Diyos, pagka meron siyang command and we disobeyed, we have accountability. Just like Adam, he was given one command and he disobeyed. And yet, the Israelites were given 613 law and commandments. Who will be able to really comply with all this? So, makita natin na God will always start us with the general will. When God called my life, hindi naman yung sinabi, Grace, pastora ka, Grace, missionary ka, Grace, propeta ka. No, there's no specific like that. Basta sabi lang niya, follow me. You know, what Christianity is all about is following Christ. Ministry is just an expression of our intimacy from Jesus Christ. Kaya lang, ang hirap sa maraming nasa ministry, wala pang relationship kay Jesus Christ, nasa ministry na. Ano ibibigay niyo sa tao? Wala. You're giving people empty words. That's why people have not been transformed. Hindi na bago. You know what transformed the people? It is the work of the Holy Spirit. When the anointing hits us, when the preaching hits us because of the anointing, that gives us conviction. And that's once we are convicted and follow through with the conviction, then transformation will happen. Kaya lang hindi yan natatapos yan sa conviction. It must be followed through by obedience. Kasi obedience will really change us. It's not knowledge, head knowledge. Marami akong kilala. Alam nila ang Genesis to Revelation, but no change. Hard pa rin ang heart. So, it's importante po sa atin na we know the word and we apply the word. Kaya general will sa umpisa, and then He will wait for us to mature. What is that? What does it mean to mature? Hindi yung marami accomplishment, okay? You know, the maturity in the eyes of God, your heart becomes softer and softer. Mas palambot ng palambot sa kalooban ng Diyos. Hindi ministry, hindi accomplishment. Okay? And then what? Pag malambot na, He's ready to give the specific will. How do we achieve that? By renewing our mind. Remember what the Word of God, Romans, I think, Romans 12:2, be not conformed to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will know what is the good, pleasing, perfect will. God will not reveal His good, His pleasing or acceptable and perfect will without renewing of the mind. That's why He cannot give the specific will if our mindset is tuned always in the world. Kaya nga sabi niya, set our mind on things above and not on earthly things. So, kailangan po natin, have you been seeking God about the general will until we are in the perfect will? Ang specific will na niya. Masasanay ka niya. Pero kunyari, there are times now I have an appointment, so sabihin ng Panginoon sa akin, don't go, okay, I will not go. Pag sinabi, okay, go, I'll go. Mga specific na, yung mga daily life na bakit nasanay na ako eh, na marinig siya. Kaya sabi niya, my sheep hears my voice. Are you hearing God's voice? The lamb does not hear God's voice. Immature yun. But the sheep represents what? Matured one. So, we need to understand God will give us the general will because He's waiting for us that our hearts will be soft, tender towards Him. Kasi pag specific na, there's no room for mistakes. There's no room for disobedience. It must be precise. I'll do it, Lord. So, if we are still in the general will, nakakalungkot po. We need to come to a point that we are hearing God for specific will na. Because when you are getting specific will, it speaks of what? You have really matured. The trip into Egypt teaches us several things. Egypt, which represents the world, is not the place to go for help. Okay? When we are in trouble, kasi tayo madalas tayong tumakbo sa mundo. And we should not. Okay? In this case, however, God had a reason for Abraham going to Egypt. Many times, God warned His people not to return to Egypt for help. Sabi yan sa Isaiah 30:1-3. Woe to the rebellious children, says the Lord, who take counsel but not of me, and who devise plans but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin, who walk to go down to Egypt and have not asked my advice to strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh and to trust in the shadow of Egypt. Therefore, the strength of Pharaoh shall be your shame and trust in the shadow of Egypt shall be your humiliation. How many pastors have given up on their call and went back working and even going abroad? Kasi sabi nila, they really want to help the ministry. They want to, kasi quote na lang yung title. So, ibig sabihin, kaya ka nag-serve because of money. You see, when you, totoo yung word of God eh. Sabi doon na, when you seek first His kingdom and His righteousness and all these things shall be added. Pag inuna mo kung paano ka paghaharian ng Diyos, at i-apply mo yung kanyang salita ng Diyos, lahat ng pangangailangan natin, idadagdag na lang niya. Ano yung sabi idadagdag? So, ibig sabihin, meron na. Remember, when God created Adam and Eve, anong inuna niya? He created the earth, what? Everything that man needs, the herbs, the trees, the sea, the water, everything. Why? And then what at the last day, what? Ang last creation niya was man. Bakit? He made provision first before He created man. It only speaks that God is a good provider. If He can do that to Adam and Eve, He provides everything first, then He created Adam and Eve. What more po ngayon that we are in the New Testament that God's promises are true? Bakit po natin gagawin on our own strength to finance the ministry, to finance what? Our project. My principle in the ministry is, if God will not provide, I will not do it. But when God says something in my life and I don't have much, I don't have money, but by faith, I step out in faith, then nakita ko, all these are added unto me. Inuna ko eh. Kasi I believe the faithfulness of God. Kasi sa atin madaling magsabi na, God is faithful. Yes, God is faithful. people. Is it true in your life? God is good. Sabihin natin, yes, God is good. Is it true in your life? Sabihin, yes. Can you show the fruits that you are believing that God is able, that God is a good provider? Kaya kailangan maintindihan natin na hindi yan sa salita eh. Pinapakita dapat. So we need not to really rely on the world. Don't go back to the world if you are called to be in full-time ministry. I am called to a full-time ministry. And God never failed me when it comes to provision. In fact, I've been a blessing to many ministries, especially to the mission work. Wala naman ako hinihingian. Kasi it only shows God is faithful. Totoo. Naniniwala ako dun eh. Kasi tayo minsan lip service lang. Naniniwala ba tayo that God is faithful, that God is able, that God is good? Minsan, ano lang tayo, amen lang tayo ng amen, pero it doesn't prove anything in our life. So I pray that this will really convict us. If you're called to a full-time at talagang pinag-give up sa'yo, then give up. Kamatakot. Hindi ka na magugutumin eh. Kailan ba tayo ginutom ng Panginoon, di ba? And besides, when Abraham went to Egypt, I think he got Hagar when he went to Egypt. Okay? So, and then next, he allowed, hindi pa. Okay. He allowed Lot to pick whatever land he wanted. Kasi po, sinabi ng Panginoon sa kanya na leave your family, leave your land, leave your family, leave your, what's this, relatives. Dinala niya si Lot. Being with Abraham, Lot was blessed. When you're connected with godly people, you become enriched in your life. Nabe-blessed ka din. If you're in the right people, godly people, you're surrounded, it tends to really, alam mo yun, yung blessings ni Lord, ang bilis mag-flow. Napakagaan. Okay? So, si Lot, yumaman din. Kaya lang, yung servants nilang pareho, nag-aaway-away. Kasi nga, marami na silang, ang richest kasi doon ng wealth is based on the flocks and the animals that you, gain. So, he allowed Lot to pick whatever land he wanted. So, makita mo si Abraham, napaka-generous. Inuna niya si Lot. Sige, mamili ka kasi kailangan tayo maghiwalay eh. Kailangan natin maghiwalay. So, inalaw niya si Lot, mamili ng una. Men who have the call and promises of God possess great inner strength. Ibig sabihin ng great inner strength, walang insecurity yan. Okay? They never cling to their possessions or worry about them being taken away by others, but rather hold them loosely. Parang hindi ka ma-insecure. Kasi ang napapansin ko rin dito sa mga different ministries sa churches, pag umattend sa isang church, nagagalit sila. Why are you angry when they wanted to really learn to grow in the knowledge of God? Let us open our church, open to others, attending to others. Baka naman kasi hindi natin napipid ng maayos, kaya naghahanap yan. Di ba? Ikaw, pakainin mo yan ng pakainin ng lugaw araw-araw. Eh, maghahanap na ng karni yan. So, ang nangyayari kasi, with my experience, pagka pupunta ako sa isang lugar and they heard na, oh, andito si Pastora Grace. Alam mo, they will slander me, they malign me, kasi ayaw nila yung mga tao na pupuntahan sa akin. Hindi ko naman sila aagawin because why? Secured ako eh. Hindi ko kailangan mang-agaw eh. Pero yung mga walang inner strength, hindi sila secured what God has called them, they tend to really, maninira sila ng kapwa nila Christian, kapwa nila pastor. Just to what? To prove that they're above and that person is nobody. I mean, sabi ko nga, Lord, bakit ganito ang body of Christ? We are so divided. Because of what? Insecurities. You have to overcome that insecurities. Huwag po tayong matakot kung aalis ang tao. Ako, I'm not afraid when people leave the ministry, when people, for the reason of what, na ayaw nila, hindi sila contented, that is my fault. I'll come to God, na Lord, nagkulang ako as a leader, so make me a better person, make me a better leader. But for me, na mga ngaway, na mga ano, magninira, I don't do that. I don't have to do that. Because I believe that it is God who called me, it is God who will accomplish that. You see, ministry, when God gives us a task, it's always impossible. Pag kaya natin yung pinagagawa ng Panginoon, hindi kay Lord yan. Kasi napansin ko, pag may pinagagawa si Lord, lagi hindi natin kaya. Why? Because God wants us to do it by faith. And then what? So that we will depend on Him. Kasi pag sinabi natin, ah, kaya ko yan. Ay, naku, mga kapatid, that's arrogant. Kaya nga ministry, when God gives you a task, it's always impossible. Kaya nakaka-overwhelm. Minsan mga pinapagawa sa akin ng Panginoon, sabi ko, Lord, nakaka-overwhelm. Why? Because I will depend on God. Then what? Ang mangyayari dyan, it is impossible. The next stage is, it is difficult. Napakahirap. But the thing is, it is done by the power of God. Ibig sabihin, when all these are accomplished, you cannot take the glory. Bakit? Hindi ako yun. Kasi hindi ko kaya yun in the first place. So, sino magte-take ng glory? God. Kaya importante po na pag tayo may pinagagawa, gawin natin at huwag tayong matakot at huwag tayong ma-insecure sa, you know, the threat of other people. I've been threat, alam niyo naman yan, sa mission. I've been threat many times. Na sabi ko nga, Lord, pinagkakaisa nila ako. Ano ako ginagawa? Nagtuturo lang naman ako. But the thing is, you know how God defends me? I never defended myself. I always ask the Lord, Lord, defend me according to my integrity. You know my heart. I'm doing this because you asked me to do this. Not because of any motive or any intentions, but for you. Because you asked me to do this and I am doing this because this is your will. Kaya no man will be able to stand against me. Kaya nga, I will never defend myself sa mga taong to. I'll allow God to defend me. You know how He defends me? By pouring His anointing, His authority, His power, and the influence is increasing. Ganun si Lord eh. Hindi mo naman kailangan kunin ng vengeance kasi sabi niya, vengeance is mine. So, kanya yun. Hayaan mo na siya. But then, what? The heart. Yung heart, okay? Men and women with the promises of God know that ultimately they will have what God has pronounced. Yun po dapat tayo convinced. Kung ano yung sinabi ni Lord, makakamtan natin. In His own way, in His own time, and in His own will. Kasi the righteousness of God is will, His way, and His purpose. Ibig sabihin, it's not enough to be in the will of God. Okay, tinawag ka ng Panginoon, pastor ka, propeta ka, o what, missionary ka. Kaya kailangan lang, hindi natapos sa will. Yung ways niya, kailangan malintindihan natin na paano ba maging pastor? Paano ba maging leader? So these are the ways of God. And then what? Once you fulfill the will and the way, then the purpose of God is easier. Bakit? Kasi it will flow. Andiyan ka sa kalooban niya, nilalakaran mo yung paraanan niya. Paano ba maging servant ng Diyos? Di ba? I thought on the vessel of honor. So makita natin na ito pala, kailangan ito. Kasi pag hindi po, hanggang will lang tayo at hindi natin na lalakaran ng way, we'll never enter the purpose of God. Never. Kahit nasa ministry ka, does not guarantee that you're in the purpose of God. Why? Because the measurement is always will, way, then purpose. So, ang tanong, nasa Facebook po tayo. Marami kasi, oo, pastor ka, pero wala ka naman sa ways. Di mo naman nilalakaran ang paraanan ng Diyos. So, hindi mo rin nilalakaran ang layunin niya. Bakit? You can never enter God's purpose without walking in the ways of God. The reason why Moses asked, Lord, teach me your way. And then what? Let your presence go with us. In knowing and walking in the ways of God, where the presence will increase in your life, and then God will always show us His glory. You see? At ano yan eh? Connect-connect po yan. But those without the promises are the ones who will fight for and cling to possessions or position. Yan. Diyan nag-aaway-aaway yan eh, di ba? Yung nap-demote ka. Alam mo na, when 2001, God called me around 2002, 2003, God released me into a church. And the people are attracted sa life ko because when I share, pag nagsisharing lang naman kami, nabibless yung tao. And then finally, sabi ng pastor, wag daw ako mag-share. Kasi na I don't know why. Sabi niya, quiet ka lang. So hindi ako magsasalita. Tapos pagka sinatanong nila, ba't di ka nagsasalita? Eh, bawal magsalita eh. Ayaw nila ako pasalita eh. Bakit? Eh, every time I open my mouth, people are blessed. And ayaw nila yun. So okay lang sa akin. So, ayaw niyo ako pagsalitain until finally they remove me. And finally the Lord said, leave. So, yan po yung ano eh, problema natin, yung insecurity. Those who are insecure have no inner strength. The promise of God kay Abraham is two seeds. What? These are the natural, dust of the earth, the juice through Isaac. And spiritual seed starts of heaven that came through Christ. So tayo po yung New Testament seed ni Abraham. Okay, next. Up to a certain point, okay, kasi naghiwalay sila Lot, okay. How does it apply to us? Up to a certain point, Christians can walk together. There can be an agreement on certain fundamentals of the faith. But when one such as Abraham has a vision for the higher purposes of God, there will be a separation. Hindi lahat ng kasama mo, mag-a-agree kayo. Kaya there are times what happens, there are separations. Kasi, especially me on my part, okay, God will always show me the vision, the goal of the ministry. So doon ako pupunta. Kaya lang, may mga tao nasa paligid ko, hindi nila kaya yung standard ng Diyos. Because I'm one leader that will really impose the standard of God. And unfortunately, aalis sila, offended. Kasi bakit daw ganyan? Hindi sila accommodate. I will never accommodate your immaturity. After being with me and you're still immature, you're beginning to be a burden more than a blessing, and I'm willing to let go of you. Because there are so many tasks ahead, hindi tayo pwedeng maging alaga habang buhay. Kaya nga sabi ng Panginoon, make disciples. You know what? Disciples, follower of Christ. Kaya pag tinagalog mo yun, ano ibig sabihin? Alagad. Alagad. So pag tinanggal mo yung D sa huli, anong meron? Alaga. So for a season, aalagaan ka ng church, aalagaan ka. Pero kung hindi ka nagmamature, pabigat ka, what happened? So, anong mangyayari? I'm letting go. Lalo yung matatampuhin, madaling ma-offend, hindi ma-correct. You see, when you stop being teachable, you stop growing. We grow when we accept correction. We grow when we accept rebuke. Kaya tayo nako-correct kasi ayaw ng Panginoon na manatili tayo sa mali. Bakit ayaw natin tumanggap ng correction? Why cannot we submit to the authority that God has placed up over us? So mga ganito, ayaw mag-submit sa authority yan, tinatanggal yan. Okay? So minsan may nag-comment sa akin na kailangan daw inaalagaan ng mga tupa. Yes, totoo yun, inaalagaan ng tupa. Pero yung mga kambing, tinatanggal, sinisipa. Okay? Kaya pag kambing ka, ang ginagawa sa'yo, tinatanggal ka. Goat and sheep, there can never be unity in between sheep and goat. If you have no vision, you cannot one with the vision of the leader or even the church, then there's no point of joining this. Secondly, the standard of God. Kailangan yung standard ng Diyos ini-impose. Hindi yung standard ng mundo. Hindi yung standard ng pastor. I never impose my standard. It is only the standard of God on the basis of the truth. Hindi pwedeng, oh, ito, gusto ko. Kaya marami sa atin, maraming churches, what happened? Kahit ano pwede. Kahit sa music team, sa music team, may ka-live-in, may girlfriend, o may boyfriend na, hindi Christian, I do not allow that. Why? Because I impose the standard of God. If you want to be used mightily by God, you want to honor God, then we walk in His ways. Yun ang sinasabi ko, walk in His ways. Hindi tayo pwedeng nasa will, pero wala yung ways. Tapos kahit ano pwede. Hindi pwede yun. Kasi kailangan when you walk, when you are following the will of God, waste niya, kailangan nilalakaran natin. Then, that's the time you enter into the purpose of God. Without the two, no purpose. Kaya madaming gulo sa loob ng ministry. But once everyone is in the purpose of God, there is unity. True unity is when God's people are in agreement with heaven. Christ is pictured as the cornerstone of the church. The building must take its measurement from the stone. So, alam mo ba na yung cornerstone? Diyan nagmumula yung sinusukat kung paano itatayo ang building. Kasi pag hindi po siya ayon sa sukat ng cornerstone, okay? Hindi po stable ang building. Chu, bakit ano? Mahinit. So, excuse me. So, makita natin na kailangan yung standard ni Lord. Kaya nga pagka ini-impose ko yung standard ng Panginoon, okay, sa churches, especially we're growing tremendously, ang nangyayari, there are people umaalis, hindi nila kaya. Okay? God is looking for a holy people that will agree with Him. And it will flow to the leaders. Hindi pwedeng sabi ni Lord. Kasi meron, ito po yung mga experiences ko ha, in the ministry. Maraming Christians pupunta sa akin, gustong sumama sa akin, sa mission, sa church, sa ministry, dahil nabibless daw sila. But the moment I impose the standard of God, ayun na, nasi-shake na. Kasi sabi daw ni Lord, you cannot claim, sabi ni Lord, and yet you are not submitting to the authority, the leader. God will never contradict His word. God placed leadership sa ministries, organizations, so that that leader will really implement the policy or the charges of God. Ano ba yung law? Yung gusto ng Panginoon. Kaya nga theocratic ang dapat, ang church, hindi yan democratic. It should not be run by what? Board of directors, board of elders. It is only run by the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit will reveal yung direction ng church sa leader. Eh paano kung ang leader hindi nakikinig, hindi naririnig si Lord? Anong plano niya? Yung plano niya nasusunod. Kaya yung direction ng church, ano, walang pagbabago, walang transformation sa loob ng church. Taon na, may tampuhan pa rin, may chismisan pa din. Wala pa rin honesty sa pera, wala pa rin ano, turuan pa rin ang turuan. Bakit? Very sensitive pa rin. You know what sensitivity? It only shows self-centeredness. Bakit naiaway-away? It shows selfishness. Kaya nga in the last days, perilous times. There will be perilous times. Bakit? Sabi nila, perilous times. Bakit? Because of what? Self-centeredness. Kasi if we live an unselfish life, there will always be unity. It doesn't matter, hindi ako bida, it doesn't matter if they don't hear my opinion, it doesn't matter if my suggestions are ignored. As long as I want to be part of this, I want to be part, why? Because God put me here. If we are neglected, we are rejected, we are ignored, then because God put us there, then accept all what God allows in your life. Hindi yung pag na-reject ka, na-neglect, na-ignore ka, aalis ka, pupunta ka sa isang ministry, and then ganun din yung expectation mo, and then what happened? Then, frustrated ka din. Lilipat ka rin ibang ano ministry. So you need the guidance of God. Lot represents the worldly Christian whose main concern is with the things of this life. Many of them resent the message of holiness. Lifted up is the eyes, human perspective. Abraham represents the true pilgrim who is looking for the better country and city to come, heavenly perspective. Next. It is really the Lord who separates the sheep from the goats. Hindi po ako. Because when God says, alisin mo yan, aalisin ko talaga yan. Kahit sabi mo, kasi minsan magsasabi, oy, kasi kami nagbigay dito, nagbigay, I don't care. I did not ask for that. Kaya nga ako, hindi ako nasanay na, ano eh, humingi. Yung, kasi tayo, we have this Filipino ugali, utang na loob. na kailangan, may utang na loob ka, bibigyan mo ng favor. You see, the very first thing, you know, in my leadership, I never ask. And I never beg. Kaya pag when I say, when you ask me and it's not God's will, I can say no. Bakit? Hindi kita hiningian eh. Ngayon, kung sasabihin ko, wala akong utang na loob, in the first place, bakit kita mautangan na loob, hindi ko naman hiningian, binigay mo yan, sinilin mo ang Diyos. Ganun lang yun, mga kapatid. The goats do not accept the message of the cross, dying to self. Yan ang problema natin. Ayaw natin carry the cross. Sabi ng Panginoon, carry your cross, die to self. Hindi, ipipilit natin yung gusto natin. The sheep will accept the true message of the cross. I will die to myself for the sake of the purpose of God. Many times I've given up of many people, pero sabi ni Lord, tanggapin mo, kunin mo, alagaan mo. Bakit? I have to die to myself. Lord, itong mga tao to, sinaktan ako, pero sabi ni Lord, alagaan mo, ibalik mo. I have to die to myself. I'm not after what? My reputation or what? Let God build that. I will not build my reputation. It is very important for us to realize that it was not until after Lot separated that God spoke afresh. The reason God waited until Lot was gone because God did not intend the promises for Lot. So many times, may mga Christians sa ating circle, hindi siya part ng pangako ng Diyos sa buhay natin at sa ministry. Talagang aalisin niya. The Lord did not want to multiply Abram while Lot was still there. That is why God prunes His church before revival comes. We must further note that it was still many years before Abram saw the first fruits of that promise. We must cherish the promises that God gives over the years. God reconfirms, even intensifies the promises, but we are often tested by many years of not seeing it happen. This is where really it's so difficult. You go, God has a promise, and yet it's not coming to pass. Ang hirap kaya nun. Kaya minsan, di ba, may hit din ako na, did you really promise this, Lord? O baka ako lang to? That's why God will reaffirm, continue to reaffirm and confirm sa akin. Minsan, merong mga kasamaan ako sa ministry, tinanggal niya, then God will speak to me in a new way, in a fresh way. Why? Kasi hindi siya part doon. Next. So in Genesis 17:1, when Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to Abram and said to him, I am Almighty God, walk before me and be blameless. That is the requirement of God to all of us. Walk with Him. And we cannot walk with Him if we are insisting on our own will and not carrying our cross. God was commanding perfection from Abraham's walk. Remember, it requires us. We are Abraham's seed. And that tells us that we can be perfect as we walk before our Lord in obedience. Paano? In 1 John 1, 7-9, but if we walk in the light, as He is in the light, how do we walk in the light? By applying the Word of God in our lives. We have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, His Son, cleanses us from all sin. You see, when you walk with God, His blood cleanses us. And it starts from what? Walking with the light. Walking with the light, walking with God, by walking, applying the Word of God. We have fellowship with one another. You see, when we come together and we are doers of God's word, madaling magkaisa, magka-fellowship. Pero pag isa dyan, dalawa dyan, nangungontra, ayaw, mag-walk in the light, talaga hindi tayo magkakaisa, kaya tinatanggal. And the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sin. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. So, lahat po tayo nagkakamali, nagkakasala. But, sabi dyan, but if we confess our sins, it's faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. This is the problem, mga kapatid. Sabi dyan, if we confess our sins, many times we have blind spots. Minsan, kinukonfront na tayo ng Holy Spirit, kinukonvict tayo through the preaching, and yet we deny. Hindi ako yan. Nakukonvict ka, pero sinasabi, hindi ako yan. Si sister yan. Si brother yan. Sayang wala si brother. Sa kanya dapat yun. Mga kapatid, dahil ikaw ay nandito at ikaw nakikinig, para sa'yo yun. Abram becomes Abraham. A change of name increases, indicates a new position in God. Abraham has now moved from called to chosen. He has been qualified to be the model of nations. Three calling: called, chosen, faithfulness. The spiritual seed of Abraham is called to reign in this life and the next. Reigning in this life is the prerequisite for reigning the next. So okay, you have to understand. Kasi minsan po mali yung konsepto natin that meron na akong mansion sa heaven, okay na ako. You see, aim for rulership. The true reward of Christians is rulership with Christ. He will reward us with nations. So pag hindi natin na-recognize yan, napaka-careless natin. But you see, when you reign in life here, ibig sabihin, what does it mean to rule and reign in this life? That we, what? That we rule over our circumstances, every challenges, every offense, every pain, every sorrow, everything, tribulation, pressure, humiliation, lahat yan i-overcome natin. We rule over all this. We overcome all this. And then you become ruler of your what? You rule with Christ here on earth, then you will rule in the coming kingdom of God. Eh kaya lang, ang dami sa church, offended. Na-offend, umalis, nagtayo ng abandoned church. Kalooban ba ng Diyos yan? You're doing disservice to the kingdom of God. Those who receive the abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness shall reign, they shall triumph over the world. Abraham, when Abraham offered his son, it was the time when God opened. Huwag mo na ilagay sa Genesis. Just go next. Kaya, importante mga kapatid, God tests us in small things. The Christian life is comprised of little tests. Inuunti-unti tayo ni Lord. Ang kapalaki ng palaki. That are in reality getting us for the big test. Pag yung small test di mo napasa, you will not be able to face your big test. At pag hindi mo na-face ang big test, you will not be able to receive the great promises of God. Kaya, importante, we pass all the small tests until we face the biggest test in our life. The one that really counts and will affect our eternal place. It's like a school. We learn and are graded throughout the year. But the final exam is the one that counts. Remember, the Israelites failed the first 9 tests in the wilderness. It was only natural that they will fail the 10th one. The last one was the one that disqualified them. So, this test, it's either the greatest test in our life will either disqualify us or qualify us to rule and reign with Christ. After Abraham proved his obedience in giving his only begotten son, the Lord now makes an oath. Because you did not hold back your best from me, I will not hold back my best from you. We can never outgive God. He will always give us his best. But he will withhold it until we're ready to surrender our life. The fullness. Ang surrendering naman natin, di yan one time, big time. Dahan-dahan din kasi di naman natin kaya. The Lord then intensifies the promises of blessing and multiplication. So nakita naman natin, di ba? We multiplied Israelites and the seed through Christ, the Christian. Next. Abraham had passed the third qualification for reigning. What is that? Being faithful. Remember I said, the three qualifications, the called, the chosen, and the faithful. There is also additional promise included in the oath. Thy seed will possess the gates of their enemies. Di ba sabi ni Jesus Christ? The church, the Hades will not overcome the church. That is the promise of God in our life. So, have you been defeating your enemies, Satan, the world, and your flesh? God promised that we will overcome all these three. Ang pinakamahirap i-overcome sa other Christians' world. So if you cannot overcome the world, you will not be able to overcome yourself, the flesh. Because once you overcome the world, you'll be able to overcome the flesh. Okay? And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence and the violent take it by force. So how determined are you? to receive the promises of God in your life. Kailangan po, marunong po tayo lumaban sa buhay. Okay? It is good really to fight a good fight of faith. Hindi madali. Hindi po madali. Sa totoo lang. Then we'll go for the life of Lot. Called righteous man 3 times, but that too many compromise regarding the Lord's word. Made wrong choices and decision. When given the opportunity to choose, he chose the plains and not the mountains. Remember, chapter 13:10, ano sabi dyan? And Lord lifted up his eyes and saw all the plain of Jordan. It was well watered everywhere. So before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, like the garden of the Lord, like the land of Egypt, as you go towards Zoar. So maganda yung Churan, Sodom, and Gomorrah. He chose to go down rather up. Mountain speaks of the presence of God, but he chose to live according to the world. When we compromise with the world, we lose the presence of God. Lot settled in the midst of a place where God did not want him to be. We need to settle in where God wants us to be. Hindi po pwedeng nandun tayo sa lugar na wala ayaw ng Diyos sa atin. It will hinder the growth of our spiritual life. I have fellowship with many leaders and many Christians. They have disobeyed God kasi hindi naman yun ang para sa kanila, pero ininsist nila. So while fellowshipping, you can recognize na dry ang spirit nila. They have not grown. Okay. They are rich in money matters, but their spirit is so dry. In the case of urgency, when Lot was told by 2 angels to flee, he lingered. Sabi, minsan meron si Lord sinasabi sa atin, iwanan mo yan, iwanan mo na. Ang ginagawa natin, we lingered. Kaya nga sabi niya, today, if you hear His voice, listen! Hindi pwedeng mapatumpik-tumpik ka. Because why? When God says something, it is for our own good. Kaya nga, immediate. Bakit? Kasi pag naglinger ka, ang tendency, hihilain ka palayo sa Diyos. So sabi dyan, so it came to pass in Genesis 19:17, when they had brought them outside, that he said, escape for your life, do not look behind you, nor stay anywhere in the plain. Escape to the mountains, lest you be destroyed. Escape for your life, sabi dyan, do not look behind you or stop anywhere in the valley. Escape to the mountain, ang sabi dyan. Lot complained that he will not make it. Ayun ang problema natin eh. Nakarinig tayo sa Panginoon, nakakuha tayo ng command. And yet, mangangatwiran tayo, hindi ko kaya eh, nahirapan ako eh. Pinapag-ibab sa'yo, sasabihin mo, hindi ko kaya, nahirapan ako. God would have waited for him to reach the mountain, but he reached in unbelief. Sometimes we cannot act on what God is saying to us, because of unbelief. Lot had much wealth. Mayaman si Lot. But he did not have the abundant life of God because his choice is to coexist with the world, whose constant degenerate pressure virtually destroyed his true spirituality. Lot was not a sinner in a normal sense, but spiritually small and mean man. Spiritually, he's poor. Lot was converted. This is the condition of many Christians. Converted po, but carnal. He was a man of weak faith. His hopes and dreams were in the world. And his interest was in the things of this world. Lot had the same vision as Abraham, but by choice, he was firmly anchored to the world. All of Lot's goodness was virtually wasted because his spiritual life was going nowhere. Yun ang bantayan natin. Ang problema lang, alam mo problema ni Lord, God was not part of his life. Not in his thoughts, not in his decision making, not in anything about his life. He's so anchored to the world. He believed, but all his passion was spent pursuing the amusement of this world. Lot, whose faith was weak at best, was not committed like Abraham. The whole aim of Abraham's life was to give glory to God. While Lot, through the righteous, lived by sight. His aim was essentially to grasp at life, to do it now and enjoy it, rather than work to develop his relationship with God. I ask you, where is your treasure? For where your treasure is, there your heart will be. there is an interesting contrast between Abraham and Lot. Abraham was probably Abraham was probably much wealthier. Okay? But Abraham lived in a tent. Lot lived in a house. What does it mean? It clearly shows that Abraham lived his life in such a way that everybody understood he was just a pilgrim. Lahat tayo pilgrim, dumadaan lang dito. That's why do not anchor your life here on earth. Don't invest here on earth. Invest in your eternal destiny. That's why I invest in the lives of the people who have the calling. I invest money and time. I do this, the seminar and everything, because I want the body of Christ to be really aligned. Hindi po madali magturo with my medical condition. But I trusted God because I want to invest the eternal, I want to reap eternal benefits in my life. Kaya importante po, what have you been sowing in your life? So I pray that we will learn from this. Let's go to, Joseph. Wala na tayong time with Jacob and Esau. So I have to jump. We have, sabi ko sa inyo, napaka-rich po. Kinakat ko na nga lang yung mga revelation, but this is very important, the life of Joseph. I cannot allow that we will miss this, okay? Life of Joseph, we know very well as Christians, we have read that in the book of Genesis, that he was sold by his brothers to be a slave, going to Egypt, and he found he was really in Egypt, he was sold as a slave. Remember, sa Egypt, when you are being sold as a slave, you are naked. Talagang you are naked. Kasi, syempre, yung bibili sa'yo, gusto makita yung kanyang investment. Kung may sakit ba yan, kung makinis ba yan, everything as slave. But you see, Joseph was naked and he was being sold as a slave. And yet, the word of God says, he was prosperous. So you see, you must understand that prosperity is not based on how much wealth you have. It is simply because why did the Bible write that he was prosperous on that kind of condition and situation? Simply because God was with him. That's what prosperity is all about. When God is with us, we are prosperous because we lack nothing. Kaya sabi sa Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. If I allow my God to lead me, to guide me, no matter how painful the situation, as long as I know that God is with me, I'm still prosperous. I don't base my prosperity on how much I have. Because if everything I have, pag meron ako, pinamimigay ko lagi. I invest on the life of the people. I invest on the ministry of others. Why? Kasi my resources are unlimited. Nauubusan din ako, okay? Kasi minsan nire-restrain ako ni Lord kasi masyado rin akong masyadong palabigay. Okay? So, God was grooming him. Sa first muna. Every injustice was used by God to carry him closer to the throne. It is the same with us. However, if we fight injustices and demand our rights, we will disqualify ourselves from reigning. Every injustice, allow yan ang Diyos sa buhay natin. Bakit gumaganti tayo? Bakit nagre-react tayo? Gusto natin kaagad pagka nasasaktan tayo, ano gusto natin gawin? Gusto natin kaagad gusto natin patunayan. We do things para to prove ourselves. Hey, ganito ako, ganyan ako. You cannot prove yourself apart from God. Let God build your reputation that when God is the one who exalts you, people will be amazed. Mamamangha sila sa'yo, madodraw sila sa'yo. Hindi mo without effort. That's why, lagi nga, ang struggle ko nga, people are drawn to me. Sabi ko, Lord, why people are drawn to me? And I never wanted to be esteemed by man. I never wanted to be honored by man. I never desired it. And yet people praises me. Why? Because this is God's defense in my life. You see, Joseph was bought as a slave by Potiphar, captain of Pharaoh's guard. Joseph is what? He epitomized the proverb that says Proverbs 17:2. A wise servant will rule over a son who causes shame and will share inheritance among the brothers. So, makita mo, kahit slave siya, and yet he was entrusted with so much responsibilities by Potiphar, they developed the enduring qualities of meekness and faith, which are essential qualities for leadership. A lot of us are called to be leaders, and yet we're not able to be placed in a leadership because of what? You always demand your rights. Actually, there are no other ways to develop these qualities. Therefore, let us understand God's ways, as the prophet Isaiah brings out, his ways are not our ways, his thoughts are not our thoughts. So next. Joseph, when the time comes, he was really, how was that? Tempted by the wife of Potiphar. Okay? Because the wife of Potiphar wanted to have sex with him. Ayaw niya, he flee. Okay? Kaya nga, di ba sa Timothy, flee youthful lust. Pero pagdating kay Satan, anong sabi doon? Stand! Having stand, then stand! Bakit pagdating kay Satan, sabi, stand! Manindigan ka! Pero pagdating sa lust, flee! It only means we can beat Satan, but our own flesh, mahirap. Kaya we need to run away. Pagka may temptation, layas. Okay? Kaya alam mo na hindi nakalooban ng Diyos, natitempt ka na, nalalayo ka na, and yet lumalapit ka pa. Kaya si Joseph Hifley, he was in prison for standing for purity and accused of impurity. Listen, mga kapatid. There are times when we stand for what is right, we'll be accused of what we are false. When we stand for what is pure, we will be accused of impure. When we stand for a true church, you will be accused of being a cult. I've been there. But I never backed down. Okay? And I've been, nakita nyo naman, I've been persecuted and maligned. So, ano nangyari? Nakulong siya. Which is far worse now, being a slave ngayon, nakulong pa siya. But even in dungeon, in jail, he was prospering. Why? Because God was with him. Nabigyan siya ng responsibility until finally, what? Butler, the baker, came, na in prison din, nakasama niya, mayroon silang dream, na-interpret ni Joseph. Okay? So what happened? So nung na-interpret niya, kasi nga may dream si Butler at si Baker, I don't have to, I believe that you, alam niyo na po itong story na to. Joseph pleaded his case before the butler and asserted his innocence. Parang sinasabi niya, uy, pag nakawala na kayo, kasi sa dream, makakawala sila, mapifree sila sa pagkukulong. Kaya sabi ni Joseph, uy, pag nakawala na kayo, pwede bang pakisabi kay Pharaoh, innocente ako dito, nakulong ako out of wrong accusations, okay? So, sabi niya, he seek him to intervene on his behalf before Pharaoh when he was restored. So sabi niya, pag na-restored ka na sa position mo, sa butler and sa baker, ano sabi niya, pakisabi kay Pharaoh, I was put here based on the wrong accusation. Kaya lang, 2 years pa hinintay ni Joseph. Why? Deliverance is from the Lord and in His time. As much as we want to be delivered from everything, we cry out to God. Many times I cry out to the Lord, deliver me from this, deliver me from that. But then when I am trying so hard on my own, mas lalo po ako nahihirapan, lalo akong nalulubog. So I realized with this story that deliverance is from the Lord and in His time. When he was restored, the butler forgot Joseph. I mean, God can allow the butler to remember Joseph, but He allowed the butler to forget about Joseph. You see, God is sovereign. For in the purposes of God, there was a far greater deliverance. If only we will wait for God's timing and let Him do it in His way, we shall see His glory. Merong mas malaking deliverance. Ano yun? That He will deliver the nation Israel. Bakit kailangan 2 years pa? Kasi God wants to tenderize the heart of Joseph. Bakit? Kasi after si Lord i-save yung Israel out of famine. Bakit? Dahil pag si Joseph hindi handa ang puso, pag the moment he is put in that position, he has the authority to get even with the brothers. Israel, and then what? Give His revenge. Merong nakikita ang Diyos sa puso natin. Kaya the attacks, the wilderness, the trials are prolonged because the heart is not ready for the great blessing. For since the beginning of the world, sabi sa Isaiah 64, men have not heard nor perceived by the ear nor has the eye has seen any God besides you who acts for the one who waits for him. So, God wanted Joseph to wait for 2 more years. So, makita natin, Joseph had his hopes up only to be discouraged again. I've experienced that, mga kapatid. He said, hay na ako. Oh, Lord, this is it. And yet what? Bang! Hindi pa pala. I've been there, kapatid. But I never let this discouragement to put me down for a long time. Nada-down din po ako. But you see, I have to fight it out. Pero sabi ko, Lord, sige, di mo pa time. You see, you just have to really rise above. Your mind rise above. Na Lord, you are faithful. Ang alam ko, tapat ka. Help me to continue to believe. The Lord explained this period of additional waiting time of 2 years for Joseph and probably the same time for us was to tenderize, mellow, and soften our spirits before we entered into the true calling of God sa buhay natin. Minsan hindi natin nalalakaran pa yung true calling of God. Why? Kasi punong-puno pa ng galit, inggit, insecurity. Kaya marami kong makita. Sabi ko, Lord, bakit to? Nasa ministry na ganito pa yun. Sabi niya, it is His way. It is His ministry. I'm not there. I'm not part of that. So sabi ko, ano meron sila if you're not there? How many churches are like that? You build your own church based on what you want because you cannot wait on God's time because you want to prove something to others. Because you are so offended. Our gift will open many doors for us when we are ready. When we are ready, mga kapatid. Joseph acknowledged that the answer was not in him. Joseph had given several previous interpretations, but when he came face to face with a great problem, he acknowledged that it was God who had the power of interpretation, not he himself. We should beware of familiarity with the spiritual gifts and not be presumptuous. We should first seek the mind of the Spirit. Yun ang problema sa gifted people. They can operate on their own emotion and their own opinions without the Holy Spirit guiding and leading that person. Kasi familiar ka na. Before we can be fruitful in Christian life, we must ask God grace to forget all things that have been done against us. Joseph's first son was Manasseh. Am I right? Manasseh. And then, Ephraim. So, what the Manasseh? What happened? Why is Manasseh forgetful? He has to forget all the pain. And then what? The next son was named Ephraim. What does it mean? Fruitful. The only way to become fruitful in the ministry is for you to forgive, forget the past hurts. You cannot hold on to your past hurts if you really want to serve God. Let go of the past. Balik doon. When Joseph met his brothers after 22 years of separation, he was able to show forbearance and forgiveness. Joseph was able, without malice, to receive them and test them to see if they had truly repented of their sin. There is no forgiveness unless one acknowledges his sin. You can forgive, but there's no fellowship, reconciliation. Reconciliation lies in the valley of humiliation and severe testing. One cannot reconcile with just a sweet word. Reconciliation means the rejoining of hearts and minds in joyful unison. Therefore, a work of grace has to be accomplished in the hearts and lives of those whose fellowship has been rent asunder by sin. Kailangan po may grace. There are two sides of forgiveness. In the case of, we see Joseph's side and the brethren's side. Okay? Joseph had nothing in his heart. If you study Joseph, kala natin, nagmamatigas siya. Hindi siya nagmamatigas. Okay? Hindi siya nagmamatigas. He was testing the brothers. Joseph had nothing inside, but his brethren still had to be reconciled to Joseph, and they needed to have work done in their hearts. Bakit? Without realization, anong ginawa mo, there is no reconciliation. There are two sides to reconciliation. God is willing for everyone to be saved, but not everyone is willing to be saved or to repent for offending God. God is willing to forgive us, but are we willing to repent and to really acknowledge our sin? In the same way, we want to be reconciled. Do you acknowledge? There are people who want to come back to the ministry who have left or have been expelled. Ang gusto nila ito, bisitahin mo ako, ganituhin mo ako. No. Sabi ko, no. Be reconciled to God first before you reconcile to us. Because if you are not reconciled to God, ibig sabihin you have not realized what happened, why you left, and why you were expelled. So pag binalik mo yan, at walang realization, dala-dala pa rin niya yung issue niya in the past. Bakit ko tatanggapin yan na samantalang magkakaproblema na naman yan? Kaya until may realization, that Christian na bakit ka naalis at bakit ka umalis, then there's no reconciliation. But that's not mean I have not forgiven. I have forgiven. I can talk to you face to face without any prejudice nor any anger or bitterness, but no fellowship. Joseph showed a deep understanding, appreciation of the ways of God when he said 3 times that it was God who sent him into the land of Egypt. 3 times sinabi ni Joseph yun. Bakit? Naintindihan niya eh. Ginamit lang ng Panginoon yung inggit at selos, yung animosity ng mga brothers niya para itapon siya sa Egypt. Imagine na-realize ni Joseph yun. Kailan niya na-realize yun? Nung nakulong siya. When he was at the bottom, when he hit rock bottom sa life niya. Sometimes when we hit rock bottom, there's the time that we can really receive from God. Lord, give me understanding. The reason why we need understanding from God, and God gives understanding to those who fear Him. He will never give understanding to those who continue to harden the heart. Kaya maraming Christians na taon na nasa wilderness pa rin. Bakit ganyan ka pa rin? Bakit ganyan pa rin ang sitwasyon mo? Hindi ka na nabago, hindi ka na naging productive, hindi ka naging effective as Christians. Remember, we are called to be a witness. He recognized God's hidden hand behind every injustice. I saw that in my life. Every pain, every humbling season in my life. Nagagalit ako, nasasaktan ako. But ang lagi kong iniiyak, Lord, help me understand. So I will not dwell on this hurt and this pain. Because when I understand, Lord, then I can cooperate with you and I can submit to you humbly, willingly, cheerfully, without having reservation. When God gives me understanding, then it's just a matter of, Lord, give me the grace to accept what you wanted in my life. In 2020, when God said, I allowed all this grace, because from 2020, pagpasok ng January, terrible na yung mga dinadaanan ko. And God said, I allow it because what? I have established you in my perfect will. I was walking in the good, pleasing and acceptable. Now, I'm in the perfect will. And no man, and no Satan, and no weaknesses can take me away from the hand of God. Bakit? Naitanim na ako eh. When you're in the perfect will, wala nang makakaalis sa'yo dyan. That's what I discovered. Not your weakness, not Satan, not adversities, nothing. Parang sinabi ni Lord, ugat ka na yan, dyan ka na. But it's a matter of, yes, I understood. When God made me understand what had happened to me 2020 of January, and then what happened. It's a matter of, Lord, help me to accept your perfect will. Hindi ko kaya. Hindi ko kaya to. But I'm willing. God is just looking for people who are willing. Hindi naman yung sinabing kayanin mo eh. Kasi hindi talaga natin kaya eh. Ang sinasabi lang ni Lord, handa ka ba? Willing ka ba? Yes, I'm willing. Pero hindi ko kaya yan, Lord. Kasi pag sinabi mo, akaya ko yan, hindi kay Lord yan. God will never give us something that we can. Because He wants us to overcome. How can we be an overcomer when we never face something that's greater and bigger than us? So it must be something overwhelming that, Lord, I cannot make it unless you are with me, unless you hold me, unless you preserve me. That's the reason why we will always cry out to God. That's why it's important to seek Him. It's important to live in the presence of God. He understood that injustices are God's means of promoting men and women to immense blessing. Joseph Baker basically said, vengeance belongs to God, not to me. Until we are able to see the hidden hand of God behind injustices, we will never have the victory and will always fight back with vengeance. I never fought back in my life. Vengeance is mine. Like yung sinasabi, I will never take vengeance from the hand of God. Let Him. And this is one thing that God taught me also. Okay? You know that you have a change of heart after all the pain that you have gone through? Hindi na tayo kasi madaling mag-pray na, Lord, sinaktan ako, bigyan mo ako hustisya. Ganyan tayo, humihingi tayo hustisya eh. But you see, I appreciate the work of God in my life kasi yung mga nakasakit sa akin, imbis na sabi ko, Lord, bigyan mo ako hustisya sa mga tao nakasakit sa akin, at sinabi ko, Lord, huwag mo na sila kayaan mag-slip ng consequences of what they did to me. Ako na lang yung nasaktan. Okay lang ako masaktan because alam ko nandiyan ka. Kakayanin ko to dahil kasama kita. Hawak mo ko. Pero sila, hindi ko, not assured ko kasama kanila. When they suffer the consequences, kawawa sila. Ako, I can take it, Lord, kasi alam ko kasama kita. I'm not confident. That's why I can pray, Lord, sige, ako na lang. Huwag na sila. Do not let the vengeance run its course. And that is the time that I saw the heart, the work of God in my heart. That I can really allow God, no, Lord, even the word says, vengeance is mine, no. Lord, do not let the vengeance run its course. Forgive. Have mercy. We too should see the evil treatment that we receive at the hands of others as merely the means where God carries forward His plans for our lives. Moreover, when we are elevated, we must still have the forgiving and kind spirit that Joseph manifested when those who hurt us ask for our forgiveness. Madali na kang patawad. As we go on in our walk with the Lord, He will lead us into vicarious suffering. Sabi ni Paul sa 2 Corinthians 4:12, death works in us, but life in you. May pinapatay siya sa atin yung self, and yet it will give life to countless lives. Why? Because the transformed life in us that was imparted to others, it will bring conviction, it will bring transformation. Therefore, we should be good to those who despitefully use us, that our persecutors might become foreordained children of our Heavenly Father. Ilang taong nakasumakit sa hurt me, caused me pain. What happened? I prayed for their salvation. And then what happened? Pagka nag-pray na salvation, syempre, una, hindi mo mapapag-pray, pero dahil nabago ka na, kaya mo na, Lord, pinipipray ko, maligtas din sila, makakilala rin sila sa'yo. Bakit inalaw ni Lord yung tao na to, saktan ka? Para when you have a change of heart, you can pray for that person and that person will receive salvation. Kaya masabi ng Panginoon, I'm looking for a man who will stand in the gap. Ano yung sabihin? Sige, ako na lang, Lord, ang masaktan. Ako na lang. Pero yung iba na nakasakit sa akin, grant them salvation. Ginamit mo sila to change me at the same time, I pray for them, now they have their salvation. Sino talo? Wala! Panalo lahat, pati kalaban natin. Ang talo, kaaway. That's what it's all about, mga kapatid. Hindi enough na alam natin ang Word of God. Are we applying the Word of God? Is the Word of God true to us? Yes, inapego, siniraan ako, ang daming purposes ng God, ang daming ministry na apekto sa paninira sa akin. Ang daming investment na nasayang because of paninira sa akin. But at the end, because of this pandemic, anong nangyari? Zoom session, nag-widespread. Seminar, the gospel has been preached to what? to many places. Yun ang reward sa akin ni Lord. How many are now being rich through Zoom, through FB, because of my preaching? And people are blessed. This is how God rewards us. Life to the kingdom. Not just wealth. Life to the kingdom so that the kingdom of God will be advanced. That's what Christianity is all about. Ano ba ang pagkaalam niyo sa pagiging Kristiyano? Mag-church lang and then pag-uwi, away pa rin? Walang pagbabago? Sisihan pa din? Happy-happy pa rin? Kanya-kanya pa rin? Insecure pa rin? Away pa din? How can we be effective to the world when we live like them? The reason why God said, I will clothe you with power to be my witness. Kaya kakayanin natin dahil may kapangyarihan. Andiyan ang biyaya ng Diyos. Andiyan ang presensya ng Diyos. You know what? I don't have reward in this life. All I have is always sacrifices, sufferings, lahat. Lagi na lang ako magpaparaya. Ako na lang magpapakumbaba. Ako lahat. Sabi ko, Lord, minsan napapagod din ako. But you know, the greatest reward I have received from God is the presence of God. That's us. You know what? In my medical condition, sabi ko, Lord, napapagod na ako, may sakit. Ayoko na may sakit. Ang hirap. Okay? May times, ang daming test. Sabi ko, Lord, ayoko na magpa-test. There's times, gusto ko na rin give up yung medicine ko, but then, I cannot. There are people waiting for me. If I did not allow God to work deep in my heart, there will be no session like this. There will be no Zoom session every time. I'm amazed at Zoom session. I mean, every time it's spreading to the US, to Canada, to everywhere, sa Dubai, and everywhere. Hindi ko magawa yun. Nasa mission work ako. Pinagpunta ako ng Davao, Bohol, Lanao, o sa Buanga. Hanggang doon lang ako. Pero pagdating, yun lang. Pero now what? What the enemy meant for evil, God turned it around for the blessing. All things work for the good of those who love God. It worked for me. It will only always work for you too if you allow God to work in your heart. How much are you willing to surrender your rights? In Philippians 3:12-13, I admit that I haven't yet acquired the absolute fullness that I'm pursuing. But I ran with passion into His abundance so that I may reach the purpose for which Christ Jesus has laid hold of me to make me His own. I don't depend on my own strength to accomplish this. However, I do have one compelling focus. I forget all of the past as I fasten my heart to the future instead. What are you aiming in life as a Christian? What is your goal? Sabi dito, he ran with passion into his abundance. What is your life? Jesus Christ came to give us abundant life. It's not having more money, more possessions, more material wealth. No. What is your abundance in life? You know my abundance in life? The presence of God, the grace of God, the revelation of God. And I run towards that. Sabi nga, the violent take it by force. I'm so determined na, Lord, I'm not gonna lose in this life. I'm not born to be a loser. I'm born to be a victor. Ayoko magpatalo sa nakakasakit sa akin. Ayoko na magpatalo sa circumstances ko. Ayoko magpatalo kasi there are so much great things from God that's in store for me. And I don't wanna lose that. I don't wanna unclaim those inheritance, those promises simply because what? Na-offend ako, nasaktan ako, and I want to fight for my rights. Ayoko yun. Hayaan mo na yung rights mo. Hayaan ko na yung reputation ko. Ano ba naman yun? One way or the other, makakalimutan din ng mga tao yung paninira sa'yo. You know what? God can override the slander, the criticism, because once you stand and God use you, He will empower you to show that He is with you and He you have His approval. And that's my defense. Kaya sabi niya, I run with passion into His abundance that I may reach the purpose for which Christ has laid hold of me. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Para makamtan ko, layunin ng Diyos kung saan inangkin niya ako. Yun ang ibig sabihin, grace, inangkin na kita. Okay? So, nung inangkin na ako ng Diyos, hindi na ako magde-depend sa sarili ko. Sabi niya, I don't depend on my own strength to accomplish this. Sagot mo na ako. Kaya I always pray, Lord, di ko kaya to. You know, for the past few days, medyo hindi maganda pakinandang ko. But you see, Lord, I will be teaching 2 hours, more than 2 hours. So, ano gagawin ko, Lord? But I depend on you. Why? Dahil inangkin mo na ako. Sa'yo na ako eh. Hindi mo naman ako ipapahiya eh. Okay? So, I do have one compelling focus. Ano yung focus ko? I forget all the past. Kinakalimutan ko. Nakaraan na yun. Tapos na yun. Let's move on. I fasten my heart. Para bang tinali mo, parang tinako mo yung puso mo kung ano yung meron ka, meron hinanda sa'yo sa future ng Panginoon. Is that awesome? Is it worth every pain, every sorrow, every frustration, every disappointment and discouragement? They're all worth it. The rewards are overwhelming, outstanding, far greater than what you have experienced. Kaya nga sabi niya kay Abraham, I am your exceedingly great reward. If you're not satisfied with Jesus, then nothing can satisfy you. But if you believe that Jesus is your great reward, then Jesus is worth it all. Jesus is in more than enough. Remember, I shared this testimony. I remember this in one of my conferences, sabi doon. There was a woman who was converted to Christianity in the midst of a Muslim nation. And then she was mocked and she was raped by several men. And she was tied to a tree. And she was being mocked. So syempre, sakit mo, di ba? She was raped for, siguro, baba, hindi lang lima. Tapos tinali siya doon, minamak siya. So it was wounded, scarred, and everything. Then sabi niya, oh no, nasanay yung Diyos mo, ganun. So umiyak siya, she was about to give up because that's so terrible experience. So what happened? So sabi nung nagmamak sa kanya, oh, is it worth it? Is it worth it? So naisip niya, is it worth it? And then finally, God, Jesus appeared to her and sabi niya, don't ask if it's worth it. Ask yourself, am I worth it? You know, that testimony really touched my heart. Ang sabi ko kay Lord, every pain, if I gain you, you're worth it all. You are worth it all. Ano ba naman yung isa sacrifice ko compared to what I will receive from you? That's nothing. I gain more. So I pray with all this study will help us really to run a race, finish it to the end. And be faithful. I'm telling you, because I've been there, Christianity is not a walk in the park. It is a hard walk. Ministry is a painful work. But if you will ask yourself, is Jesus worth it all? I can answer you 101%. He is. There's no other way. Amen, Uba. Let's pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, for your lesson to all of us. Allow this message to enrich our lives, O God, to comfort us that every pain and sorrow in life for your cause, for your name, for your kingdom's sake, it's all worth it. If we just submit to you and humble ourselves before you, we desire, O God, to really experience the resurrection life you said in your word, O God, that while we were yet sinners, O God, we were reconciled to God through the death of Christ. It is now more certain that we are reconciled, that we shall be delivered daily on sin's dominion through the resurrection life. We want to experience that resurrection life in us that will be able, O God, to obey you, Lord. Lord, help us to forget what is behind us and keep pressing toward what's ahead, because we know that the great things, the great promises, the great inheritance are before us if we will not give up. May we learn, O God, to surrender our rights, surrender our reputation, surrender everything, O God, our desires, our will, and only your will, and we walk in your ways so that we can really live your purpose. Father, thank you for this time, for the opportunity, O God, to minister to your body of Christ as your servant. Thank you for what you have given me, rewarded me in all this time. Truly, it's all worth it. I pray, O God, that your people will be blessed. Continue, Lord, to work in their hearts deeply, powerfully, yet sweetly, O God. Break them, O God, so that they will know how to be free in you. Father, thank you for the strength, for the enablement that I was able to finish. Lord, thank you until I will meet again, my brothers and sisters. Lord, I speak shalom to everyone. We are blessed beyond our highest comprehension in Christ Jesus, if only we will know and believe that. Let us discover that. Let your people know and discover all this. Enlighten them by bringing light to their hearts, O God. Salamat, salamat po. Purihin ka. Binabalik ko po ang lahat ng papuri at pasasalamat sa pangalan po ng iyong anak na si Jesus. Amen. God bless you all.